Hello everybody, welcome to the CSS3 course. In this video, I'm going to talk about the setup of the backgrounds in a web page. As the beginning, I would like to show my web page together with this HTML file corresponding to this web page. So I have a number of parts shown on the web page. I'm going to apply some background color, and then I'm going to apply some background images on different divisions. Okay, so for the division here, I have a class identifier, and for the other division, I have another class identifier. Same for many more classes. And also, I'm going to show you the ways to change the background size. So we have a lot of classes, and finally, I'm going to show you the way to change the background image position. So I have another two divisions to help me illustrate this idea. Okay. So let me go back to the beginning. Suppose I just want to change the background color of a certain element. How can I do that? I can go to the class shown here. If I want to set up the background color for this particular division, I can do something like this. Okay, I just use the background color attribute, and then I add the color. So this attribute value pair can help me set up the background color. And after that, I'm going to show you the way to insert an image as the background. So let me see the background here. I've already set up a background image, which is that small. Okay, so I'm going to show you some ways that can utilize this small image to build up your background. Okay, so let me go to class 2. And I have a paragraph here, which is this one. So I can set up the background image shown previously to complete the entire element. Okay. You can see that I simply used this attribute value pair to repeat the background image along the horizontal and vertical directions. So background image is an attribute. The value can be represented by a built-in function called URL. And I just put the file name of my image as the parameter of the URL function. Okay, so in this case, we can see that the image is repeated along both the X and Y directions. And this repetition is also a default operation of image setup. Okay, if we just want to repeat the background image in one direction, we can actually use other attribute value pairs to help me do so. So let me go to class 3 here, which is representing this element. Okay, for this particular action called background repeat, I can just control the repetition along the X direction. So I use repeat hyphen X as the value for this attribute. Similarly, we can do the repetition along the Y direction. I'm going to do this operation on another paragraph. Okay, you can see that the image is repeated along the vertical direction, which is known as the Y direction. Okay. So we can do the repetition along each of the directions. And how about the situation when I just want the image to appear once instead of repeating itself all the time along both directions? I can have another idea like here. If I use no repeat as the value of the background repeat attribute, I'm able to use just one image as my background. So you can see a lot of blank spaces for my background. Okay, it happens because I use the no repeat value. After that, I'm going to tell you the ways to change the background size. So for my previous examples, the background size is simply obtained from the file directly. I didn't change the image size for the background. So if I really want to change the background size, I can do something like this, starting from this element, okay? Okay, I can set up a background size attribute, and my current value for this attribute is cover. So what does it mean by cover? You can see that my entire image has been enlarged quite heavily to cover the width of my element. So when I enlarge the window, I'm also able to see the enlargement of my image. So the enlargement will cover the entire width of my viewport window. So we can say that the cover value would help me utilize the image width. So the width of my background will be dependent on my viewport width. Similarly, I can set up the background size to be dependent on the viewport height. Okay, I just used the value called contain for my attribute called background size. So in this case, I'm able to just magnify or change my background image size to cover the entire height of the element. So when I increase the width of the viewport window, you can just see that the image will be shrunk to a smaller size. So the word contain shown here is simply going to help me utilize the image height to become the background size. Okay, so the background size with the value called contain will be dependent on the element height. After that, I'm going to talk about the background size controlled by the numbers directly. So now I have a background image put underneath the element, which is a paragraph. And if I want to change the size of the background image, I can do something like this here. Okay, I just set up the size of the background image by using two values. So these two lengths correspond to the X value and the Y value of the image respectively. So the width here is 150 pixels and the height of that image is 60 pixels. So you just put two values to represent the size of the background image. So this is another way rather than using contain or cover keywords, okay? For the previous examples, I'm not able to really change the background image position. In this case, every single image will start at the very first position, which is simply the top left corner, okay? So if I want to set up my background image in any other position, I can make use of other attribute value pairs to do so. Okay, I can set up the background position attribute with these two values, left and bottom. So I simply say that the position of the background image is on the left hand side and it should be put at the bottom of the element. So I will be able to put the background image on the lower left corner, okay? So these two values represent the horizontal and the vertical positions of my image relative to the element. Okay, so these two position values are measured relative to the block element, which is simply this paragraph, okay? In addition to putting two values as the value of the background position attribute, I can put four values. Okay, what does it mean by having four values? I'm able to see that the background image is shifted from the left by 200 pixels, and it is also shifted from the bottom by 30 pixels. So when I put four values as the background position values, I'm able to specify the amount of the shift from the left hand side and the amount of the shift from the right, from the bottom side. Okay. So we can have four values instead of two values alone to provide a more precise shifting of your background image from the positions shown before the actual shift value. Okay, so we can see that there are a number of ways to help me set up the background image. For example, I can simply set up the image repeatedly along X or Y directions. We can also change the background size to cover the entire width or the height of the element. We are also able to set up the background image positions with the use of some keywords corresponding to the background position attribute. This is the end of the video. If you have any questions about my video, please leave your questions on the comment section below the video. If you like this video, please give me a like and please subscribe to my channel. Thank you for watching.